Welcome class 8 students, it's a beautiful rainy monsoon season and we are going to study about ecosystems in which we are first going to study about interactions between biotic and abiotic components of the ecosystem. Both the components share a give and take relationship. The abiotic components supply the organic and inorganic nutrients to the producers, that is plants, and plants make food by photosynthesis, passing it on to the consumers and decomposers, finally release these complex materials into as simple forms back into the environment, completing the cycling of matter. Now, as you know, plants trap energy from sunlight and store it as food in the form of chemical energy. Then herbivores eat the plants, later on carnivores. Herbivores and carnivores are finally, along with the plants, decomposed by decomposers, and energy and nutrients pass through different organisms in an ecosystem in a cycle or in a sequence. This sequence of one organism eating another organism and passing on the energy is called a food chain. A food chain shows food relationship that exists between plants and animals. In this relationship, one living thing is consumed by another. A food chain is a diagram or a chain showing what animal eats, or a chain showing the process of eating and being eaten. It comprises unidirectional flow of energy. So a food chain has the following features. Every food chain begins with green plants, that as they are the producers. Producers get their energy from sun and other nutrients from the soil and air. Consumers, like animals, consume the green plants or producers, starting with primary consumers or herbivores. Then later on, herbivores are consumed by secondary consumers or carnivores. There may be tertiary consumers feeding upon secondary consumers, and the last link of a food chain ends with decomposers or transformers or scavengers, which finally release the dead organic matter into the air, water and soil. Now, each step of a food chain is called a trophic level. So, what is a trophic level? The various links or steps representing organisms in a food chain at which the transfer of food or energy takes place. That's a trophic level. For example, there are trophic levels first one of plants or producers, second trophic level of herbivores, third trophic level of carnivores, and the fourth trophic level, which comprises of tertiary consumer or top carnivores. So these are the various trophic levels existing in an food chain of a ecosystem. Let's study a forest food chain. Food chain in a forest will consist of grasses growing in the forest, small shrubs, herbs eaten by a herbivore deer, which in turn is consumed by a carnivore like a lion or tiger. Then another food chain in a grassland, grasses eaten by grasshopper, grasshopper eaten by frog, frog consumed by a snake, and snake is finally consumed by a hawk, which is the top carnivore. In an aquatic ecosystem, there is algae in a pond, which is consumed by small fishes, and small fishes are consumed by large fishes like cat fish, which of course may be consumed by an omnivore like man, deer, etc. Then when many food chains come together, because in nature one food item may be a food source for many other animals, so many food chains may interact with each other or interconnect. So this interconnected food chains are called as food web. So a food web, like a plant such as grasses, may be consumed by grasshoppers, it may be consumed by deer, it may be consumed by snail, and grasshopper may be consumed by lizards or a frog. Lizard and frog may be eaten by a snake or a hawk or an eagle. So this way you can see grass is consumed by many other animals, and a grasshopper insect is consumed by 2-3 animals, and so on. So such interlinked food chains form a food web. We can also show food relationships and energy transfer in the ecosystem with the help of triangle-shaped diagrams called as ecological pyramids. An ecological pyramid is a graphic representation of an ecological parameter or an ecological unit, like number of individuals, biomass, or energy present at various trophic levels. Biomass means the living matter in plants or animals. The producers form the base of the triangle, and the top carnivores form the tip of the pyramid. So pyramid of numbers we are going to study. It is a graphic stepwise representation of the number of individuals present at each trophic level, with producers kept at the base and top carnivores at the top. The pyramid of number is mostly upright, with every trophic level having fewer members than the previous one. So if producers are more in number, then primary consumers will be less than them, secondary consumers further less in number than primary and producers, and the top carnivores will be the least in number. So this is a pyramid of number in a grassland. The various grasses, shrubs and herbs form the first trophic level of producers. The animals are second trophic level, like insects, herbivores like rabbit, deer form the second trophic level. The third trophic level, made up of snakes, frogs feeding on herbivores, and finally we have the top carnivore or top trophic level of eagle, birds feeding upon snakes and frogs. So this is interactions between biotic and abiotic community. Now we will learn about interactions between the biotic come into your biotic components, that is plants and animals. Both plants and animals are dependent upon each other. That means there is interdependence among them. So they form various relationships with each other, like plants provide food, oxygen to the animals, shelter, medicines, etc., clothing, while animals provide plants the means of transport to carry pollens, dispersal of seeds, and they provided them carbon dioxide as well for photosynthesis. So there are various relationships existing between living beings. They may be beneficial, while some may be harmful. We will study about such relationships like symbiosis, parasitism, and predation. Three of them. Symbiosis is a positive relationship where both the organisms involved benefit. For example, lichens consist of a fungus and an algae. The fungus provides habitat with its hyphae, as well as from the decaying matter, it absorbs nutrients and supplies it to the algal partner living with it. And the algal partner, being green, does photosynthesis and makes food. Same way, there are many microorganisms living in our intestines called as probiotics. We give them food and shelter, while they supply certain vitamins and help in digestion of food. Then we have parasitism. This is a negative relationship. In this relationship, one living being benefits while the other one is at a loss. The tapeworms, the roundworms living in human intestines, are benefited by the humans, while the humans suffer a loss as their food, their internal organs are harmed by these tapeworms and roundworms, since they produce injury in the intestine or consume the food. The organism that benefits, that is the tapeworm or roundworm, is called a parasite, and the organism that is at a loss or harmed is called a host, example human beings. There may be ectoparasites and endoparasites. Ectoparasites, which exist outside the body, like mosquitoes, ticks, lices. Then there may be endoparasites like tapeworms. In plants also there are parasites. Cuscuta or amarbale is a plant parasite which feeds on other plants and trees and gradually absorb their nutrition, so they slowly die out while the cuscuta flourishes. The third category of relationship between biotic organisms is predation. In this also, the relationship is negative. One organism benefits, the other one is at a loss. For example, a snake and a frog. Frog is hunted by the snake and killed and eaten. And the snake flourishes over here, benefits, while the frog is at a loss. The one who hunts and kills another organism for food is called a predator. Snake is a predator, while a frog is the prey, because it is the organism that is hunted and killed by another organism for food. So let's study the definitions. Symbiosis is a relationship between organisms of two different species living together with mutual benefit to each other. Parasitism is a relationship in which one organism depends on the other organism for food, but the second one does not get no benefit. Predation is an interaction between two species in which one kills and eats the other. Let's study an ecosystem like a forest, which consists of both biotic and abiotic components. Wild plants, animals, microbes are the biotic components formed at various trophic levels of producers, consumers, and decomposers. Producers include annuals, biennials, perennials, plants living for 1 year, 2 years, and for several layers. There are various layers in a forest. Tall trees form the crown of the forest, the topmost layer. There's a middle layer formed of shrubs and tall grasses, and the forest floor forms of fallen leaves, fruits, seeds, grass, twigs, herbs, fungi, bacteria, etc. So this way, trees form a canopy. Consumers are herbivores, which are animals or non-green plants like fungi. Herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, scavengers. Herbivores are deer, goat, bison, the wild bull, buffalo, elephant, parrots, and many other animals. Carnivores are secondary consumers: tiger, lion, panther, fox, hawk. There are omnivores eating both plants and animals like crow, bear. Then scavengers like hyenas, jackals, vultures eat on leftovers left by the carnivores. Then we have decomposers of fungi and bacteria, which help to form humus, the dead organic matter lying in the soil. The abiotic factors include humidity, light, altitude, wind speed, temperature, which affect the plants, that is flora, and animals, the fauna found in a forest. Conifers and furry animals are found in mountainous forests, alpine forests, in cold climate, while broadleaf trees, deciduous trees, are found in rain forest. So this is about ecosystem, and I'll now give you exercises to do in your copies and learn. That's it. Thank you.